Exuberant, right? Hello, everyone. I hope everyone can see my presentation. Let's imagine 7 a.m. Monday, early in the morning. You woke up. Not you just woke up. Your alarm clock disturbing your sweet dream. So you woke up and pushed the button to snooze the alarm clock for 10 more minutes. So after 10 minutes, you stand up from in difficulty from your bed. And I think everyone thinking like they're hating the whole world. They're hating their boss. They're hating their office, they're hating their colleagues, clients, and moreover, they're hating the Mondays. And the thing is that the adults have to do like this. They have to do the things that are boring and tedious. And in that case, one way that can improve this situation, I think, is gamification. Gamification is the gamification is a technique, technology that uses gaming techniques in the non-gaming processes in order to involve your customers or your employees in the processes of your product improving or your company. So let me first go through the usage of the gamification, where it can be used in the real life. Supporters of this technique saying that it can be used everywhere, but I would like to emphasize the three of them. First one is the business. Gamification in business can make boring negotiations more interesting and make your clients buy your products more. For example, like the airlines bonus programs, where you can collect some points, you can collect some miles, and then exchange them to some privileges or some bonuses. For example, like the Nomad Club from Air Astana. You can like get your bag first on the belt at the airport. The second one is the HR management. Gamification can help to build your team, to make your team more strong, and to build, to make some competition among them, and which can lead to the productivity of your team. It can be like the honor boards or leaderboards, the best employee of the month. And the third one is the marketing. In the marketing, you can use in two areas. First of them is to attract new customers, and the second one is to retain your customers. For example, like the posts, I think most of you have seen that in the Instagram. So like repost this picture or photo and you will have the chance to win new iPhone, like that. And now I would like to go through the principles of the gamification. If you want to build the gamification in your company or in your community, for example. First of them is motivation. I think it is one of the most important thing because person have to have the incentive in order to participate in your game. There are two types of incentives. First of them is desire to have fun and desire to get rid of some discomfort. In order to pass the first one, to use the first one, you can use some prizes or like status. And for the second one, it is very important you should have the very clear rules how you can get rid of this discomfort. The second one is unexpected discoveries. It can be some bonuses or new opportunities which can raise some curiosity for you and you can dive in this game. The third one is the status. Status, I think it is one of the important things in the gamification because prizes may not be so like cool for person as the status or some some like good words from your colleagues or from your management. And the third one is a reward. For example, if you are like doing well, you have a good salary, you have a, like, you know, all these bonuses. Sometimes like the usual traditional like carrot words from your management can be not so supportive for you. So it should be some like big goal, big prize that can motivate you. Now I would like to talk about some examples of using the gamification. The first one is the Nike, which built the app, Nike Run Club. So which can track your heart rate, fat burn, mileage, and etc. Combining with the gamification thing like status, the best runner, they attract more customers, and which will buy more Nike sneakers. The second one is KSL. What they're doing at the end, they're providing some training courses to their employees. So after completing the training course, you can get the badge. At the end of the year, the person who collected the most of the badges, the most number of the badges, will get some reward. And in our company, I would like to tell about it as well. We build the gamification as well for our supply side. Our supply side is a specialist. For example, new plumber coming to our platform. He starts from the level zero. After completing some task, getting some positive feedback, he will get some points. After collecting some points, he will get the level one, for example, and etc. And as well, as I said yesterday, I dealt with the Toastmaster as well. I didn't know about the passways, and I realized that the Toastmaster passways is also gamification. It has all four principles of the gamification. In conclusion, I would like to say that gamification can be used usually in the big companies where all the processes are very like has standard approaches. In the small creative teams, it is quite difficult to implement it. And I would like to encourage all of you, if you have the chance to implement the gamification in your company, do it. It can significantly improve your metrics. Thank you.